I am Dr. Yashika Gudesa. I am head of the department at Manipal Hospital, Dwarka. Today we will be talking about cervical health. First of all, I would like all of you to know what is cervix. So there is a confusion. People confuse the cervix with the portion of the neck. But cervix is the mouth of the uterus, which has to be taken care in a female. So when we talk about cervical health, all the ladies who are sexually active and who are married should take care of their cervix. Because cervix is a part which can have cancer later on if not treated in time, and if you are not neglecting your infections. Nowadays we have the best method of vaccinating ourselves. So young girls who are at your home, young children, girls around 9 years of age till the age of 14, they can take cervical cancer vaccination. It will be 2 doses before the age of 14 years, and after 14 years till the age of 45 years, you can take up to 3 doses. So it's not that key. If somebody has crossed the age of 40, they don't need a vaccination. Somebody who is sexually active and somebody who has multiple partners, they should always go for vaccination, even if their age is more than 40 years. After they have taken the vaccination, still they should go for regular cervical screening and examination of their cervix yearly. So what can be the predisposing factors? Predisposing factors can be if you have an unhealthy lifestyle, unhealthy genital hygiene, and if somebody is having chronic infections, wide discharge, and multiple partners, smoking. So all these aggravate your chances of having a cervical cancer. One thing everybody should understand, cervical cancer will not happen in a day or in a year. It takes about 10 years for cervical cancer to develop after a series of chronic infections. So treat your infections in time and get yourself checked for your cervix. Cervix is something which you will not be able to see on your own. So your gynecologist will only use an instrument like a Sim speculum to just open the walls of the vagina and see the cervix whether it is healthy or not. So go for a yearly examination to your gynecologist. Your gynecologist will do a screening. So the screening methods which are available are the old method, which is the pap smear, which is taken with air spatula, and slides are made and they are sent for the histopathological examination. So the newer method is a thin prep method, which is better, and all the cells are picked up. So nowadays we are doing with the thin prep, and somebody who has a suspicious lesion, we ask them to go for a HPV also. HPV is human papilloma virus, and for that we do the screening, and even the vaccine is given against the HPV virus. So in this way you can judge that you are going to have cervical cancer in future or not. Somebody who has a suspicious lesion or who has a erosion or who has a stage 1 of cancer, CIN1, we ask them to go for a cryocautery, colposcopy, even cervical biopsy. Cryocautery is a very good OPD method in which we can just do a cold therapy for the cervix and a new layer of cells will come up, and by this method we can prevent the early stages of cancer. So don't be scared, meet your doctor and get yourself treated at the earliest. It is not that everybody will have a cervical cancer and but everybody should go for a cervical cancer screening. So please be aware of the stages, the methods which are available in your with your doctor and in your hospital, and talk to your doctor, go for a yearly checkup, and be healthy and be aware of cervical health. Thank you.